Well, good morning, everyone. Pastor Al here. Nice to have you join me this morning. I'm going to tell you a dog story today. I don't have a video because this is a true story. It happened about 100 years ago. And back 100 years ago, not everybody had a cell phone in their pocket to take pictures and videos. You may have heard this story before because it's a story that people know all over the world. It's a name that's a story of a dog, a white Akita, named Hachio. Let me tell you his story, and I'll show you a few pictures along the way. Back in 1924, a man who was a professor in Japan, in their large city, Tokyo, adopted a young white Akita named Hachio, and he named him Hachio. Now, Hachio and him became very good friends, and the dog became devoted to his master. Now, his master didn't live right in Tokyo. He lived on the outside of Tokyo, and like a lot of people there, like a lot of people today, he actually took a train to work. He would go down to the train station in his town in the morning, ride into work. At the end of the day, he would come back on the very same train, every day at the exact same time, get off the train and come home. Hachio was very devoted to his master, and he learned his master's schedule. And so every day, he would leave his home, walk down to the station by himself, sit there and wait for his master to return, and he would greet him very happily when he came back. This went on for several years. Then a very sad thing happened. His owner died. He died while he was at work. So he never came home on the train that day, and he was buried in Tokyo, and Hachio never saw him again. But you know what Hachio did? Every day, for the next almost 10 years, he went down to the station and waited for him. Right at the same time, right as that train was coming in. At first, some of the people there who worked there were kind of unhappy to have this dog hanging out. And then, all of a sudden, a newspaper man in Tokyo heard about him. And he came down and he wrote a story about him. And Hachio became a national celebrity. People were very moved by his devotion to his master, by his desire to be there when he came home. And people started coming to visit him. They would pet him. They would bring him food. Eventually, some people there built a shelter for him. So when he came down and it was raining or snowing, he would have a place to stay. And literally for the next 9 years, 9 months, he came down there until one day he too died. He became such a big celebrity in Japan that people erected statues to him to remember his loyalty to his master, both in his hometown and in Tokyo. There are actually statues of him in the United States. There have been books written about him. There was even a couple movies that were made about him, all because people were impressed by how wonderful it was to have this dog so incredibly devoted to his master, waiting every day for him to return. It's really cool, but yeah, it's a little bit sad too. Now, I'm not telling you the story just because it's something cool. Tells you something kind of amazing about the relationship dogs have with their owners, is that Jesus tells some parables that kind of remind us of this. You know that Jesus lived a long time ago. He lived a wonderful, perfect life. He taught us lots of wonderful things. He died for us on the cross, and he rose from the grave, and he went back into heaven. But one of the things he told again and again and again was that he wasn't done, that one day he would come back. We'd never know the time. Some people thought it would happen right away. It's been almost 2,000 years now. But we know that he could come back at any time. And Jesus told us that we should always be prepared for him to return. We shouldn't let it catch us by surprise. We should all be ready and anxious for our master to come home. Just like Hachio was for his human master, we need to make sure that we don't forget about Jesus in our day-to-day life and know that one day, when we're not expecting it, probably, he's going to come back. And the world as we know it and time as we know it will all come to an end. And we will then spend the rest of eternity with God. Some of us may not live long enough on earth to see that. Others might. We don't know. But we're told to be ready. Jesus told lots of stories that basically ended with, "When I come back, you better be ready for me." So that's my encouragement to you today. I know no one wants to tell you to be like a dog, but Frankly, I think if more people were like dogs, the world would be a better place. Remember how devoted Hachio was, always anxious and ready for his master to return? We too should be anxious and ready for our master, Jesus Christ, to return back to earth so that we can be with him forever. That is pretty cool, and that's my challenge for you today. Don't ever forget that our master is coming home someday too. Thanks for listening to me, kids. You have a wonderful day. Bye-bye.
Hachiko was my grandfather Wilson's dog. Everyone called Hachi a mystery dog because they never really knew where he came from. And that's where their story began.
Hey, buddy, you lost?
One chance encounter.
He was at the train station.
I just thought you'd bring him home and talk me into keeping him.
Tomorrow morning, I'll find out exactly where he belongs.
Became.
Dad, I love him.
A miraculous story.
Does he have a name yet?
Yes, he does. Temporary guest.
Go ahead. Go ahead. No. The ball.
He's lost it.
Sorry. The dog's already been taken.
Whoa! Good work. So go ahead. Go on home.
Been here all day?
No. He just showed up 2 minutes ago.
It's amazing. Every day.
Hachi! Hey, Hachi!
You don't have to wait anymore. He's not coming back.
Based on a true story. One dog's loyalty.
Hachi
inspired a town.
Is that the dog that I've been hearing so much about?
To discover friendship can last forever.
Every day, come, same time, same place.
It sounds like it can make a good story.
Starring Richard Gere. Academy Award nominee Joan Allen, Eric Avari, and Jason Alexander.
When I hear about my grandfather, Hachi, I feel like I know him. They taught me the meaning of loyalty. You should never forget anyone that you've loved.
Hachi, a dog's tale based on a true story.
And that's why Hachi will forever be my...